Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning, everybody. Hey, welcome to Money Talk, guys. This is where we're going to have one of the greatest talks of this morning. And if you're here this morning, then you know this morning is going to be incredible just for the simple fact that we're going to be having an amazing Money Talk today. And as always, as you always know, I'm excited because this morning, as you know, this whole week, we've been on fire. Like, if you guys been having a lot of fun with me this week so far, just light up the screen green, right? Go in your participant section and light it up green if you've been having fun so far and learning a lot, because I know we've been having a lot of fun really implementing a lot of this information that is being sent your way. And, you know, like I said, I'm just doing his work in such a marvelous way. And, man, I wake up every morning just feeling fantastic, guys. Let me tell you something. I don't know if you guys are big into reading Bible, but I'll tell you, make sure you read a Psalms a day, all right? I want to get that message out to you, man. Read a Psalms a day. I started from Psalms 1, working my way through. I'm up to like Psalm 75 right now, and I'm telling you, it's doing something to me. I don't know what it is, but it's just bringing me such clarity, you know, and I really feel awesome about that. Let me tell you, man, today we're going to talk about, you know, making sure that we understand a little bit more, right? Let's talk about understanding a little bit more about creating that financial foundation. So as you know, we already talked about protection. You know, we talk about managing our debts. And today we're here to talk about emergency funds, right? Emergency funds is so important because everybody needs to have an emergency fund, right? Everybody needs to have an emergency fund. And an emergency fund is very important to have because the fact that one, you got to plan for the unexpected, right? You got to plan for the unexpected moments. But the thing is this, how do you plan for an emergency fund when it approaches itself, when an emergency approaches? What are some of the things you should have done ahead of time to be prepared for it? And the first thing what we talk about is the fact that when it comes to creating an emergency fund, you got to at least set aside 3 to 6 months of your income to, you know, in case of any sudden changes in your job, your business, or, you know, God forbid, any accidents or repairs that are needed, you had to have this money set to the side so that way you could be prepared for this emergency. And emergency do happens, guys, right? I just want to make that clear. Emergency do happen. And the problem is that, you know, it's more of when, right? And I like to say it happens at the time when we don't want it to, like, you know. So that's what the thing about emergency, and that's what makes life unpredictable. And that's the thing about life. Life is so unpredictable, right? But the only thing about unpredictability, is that even a word? The only thing about unpredictable moments is that we just got to be prepared for them, right? And we got to have things in place. That's why it's important to have a goal, right? Which is to create that financial foundation. You know, I've been always telling you guys to have a plan, which is to use the wealth formula. So if your goal is to have emergency fund, what are some of the things that you have to do? And I'm actually going to break that down for you guys today and teach you how to live on a budget. Now, how many of you guys have entered my budgeting concepts, right? Not my concepts, but the ones that I endorse. And it's done some amazing jobs for you guys, right? Living on that budget. You know, what is my spending ability every week, every month, right? It's so important because it really puts you on a steady pathway to really accomplish your goals, right? I'm telling you, I live on a budget. Literally, I live on a budget. Like, I do not go over my budget. I don't break my budget. Does it happen sometimes? I'm not going to lie to you. Yeah, sometimes it happens, right? But I tell you, I pay the price the next month because that means my budget that I should have had for next month got cut. So anything that I took out of this month budget, I take it out of, or anything I went over in this month, I take it out of next month's budget. So that means I'm cutting my budget for next month, right? So I punish myself. That's what you get. Bad boy, you should have went over your budget, right? So, you know, these are things that, you know, it really helps you to stay grounded. You know, I like to have what's called the predictable outcome, right? What is your predictable outcome? Because we are, you know, the decisions that we make. Like, you know, my favorite saying is, you know, you're one decision away from changing your future for the better, because the choice is always yours. So the choice that I will hope that you guys will choose today is to live on a budget, okay? Live on a budget. I'm telling you, remember this saying. I always tell you what my mentor told me when I first started my journey to want to better myself. He says, live a lifestyle today that most people don't want to live, and you will live a lifestyle later that most people could only dream about. And let me tell you, you can do it. So what I want you to say is that I am the master of budgeting, right? Say it with me. I am the master of budgeting. Say it one more time. I am the master of budgeting. Just one more time. One more time for the people in the back. I am the master of budgeting. All right. So I want you to say that every day. See, every day I'm giving you guys affirmations, right? I'm going to give you guys affirmations to add on to every day. So if, like I said, if you missed some of it, go back and listen for Monday and catch some of those affirmations that I'm giving you guys, because it's important that we say affirmations. Remember, we are the words we speak, we what we think about. So you got to speak greatness in yourself, and you got to speak greatness into your finances, right? So you got to remember that I am the master of budgeting. So let's talk about how we're going to be the master of budgeting, right? Because I really want to get some feedback. So I know a lot of you guys that's really been using the budgeting formula, and it's really been doing some amazing things for you guys. And I'm excited to really want to hear from you guys this morning about that, because it's doing some numbers, man. I know a few of my business partners that actually, like, literally live on that budget. And it was like, you know, it's really cool to see it, man, because you're saving so much more money. You know, you're saving more money. You're more, you're not tracking your spending, but you're mostly really, what they like to say, knowing what is your spending ability and knowing what is your quota, what is your availability, right? So one thing first, if you want to live on a budget, right? If you want to live on a budget, I like to see who wants to live on a budget. Hit me with a yes. Let me give you a big shout out. So who want to live on a budget? Right? Who think living on a budget is cool? Let me give you shout outs. I see Miss Sheila Forbes say yes, she want to live on a budget. Right? I see Miss Beverly Williams say yes, she want to live on a budget. I see Swan want to live on a budget. All right? I see Chantal Maggie want to live on a budget. Awesome. Right? And I see Miss Victoria Garden definitely living on a budget. Right? And I see Jaime Gonzalez living on a budget. All right. Let me see. Okay. I know Tiffany here would live on a budget. This is awesome, guys. I see you guys, man. That is awesome, right? I am living on a budget, right? And let me tell you, even if you're not master of your budgeting yet, that's fine. Just say it, right? Just say it every morning. Say it every day, right? Add that to your affirmations in the morning. And just remember that I am happy. Remember that, right? I am healthy, right? I am strong. I am great. Remember to say these words. They are powerful. I ams are so powerful, guys. I am debt free. You got to say these things, right? And they will happen. You know, I am whatever you want. I always say whatever you want, speak it in the atmosphere. Whatever you want, speak it in the atmosphere, and it will come to you. Let me tell you, some way, somehow, the universe will make it come to you with no problem, all right? But if you keep saying, I can't live on a budget, and keep putting down the universe, you're not going to be able to. So let me break it down here to you now. So if you didn't know, we also offer as a solution, right? What are some of the things we offer as a solution? We offer a budgeting formula. Now, one of the things about budgeting formula is that you must know two things. You must know what is your net pay and your monthly bills. Once again, you must know your net pay and your monthly bills in order to budget, right? Once you know these two things first, because a lot of people think that, you know, this whole spreadsheet concept, right? The spreadsheet concept is, I don't know. It's more you tracking spending more than you actually doing anything, guys. I want you guys to, and I know this is going to hurt a little bit. I want you guys to get rid of all your spreadsheets. Just delete it. Master, hit delete, right? Rip it out. Get rid of it. Throw it away, right? You don't need that anymore. You understand? you don't need that anymore. So that's the thing about it, the spreadsheet, like, get rid of it, guys. You don't need it no more. You don't need it anymore, okay? Don't let nobody fool you. Oh, I need a spreadsheet, blah, blah, blah. No, 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 no. You're not an accountant, okay? An accountant tracks spending, okay? You gonna know how much you could spend if you run this formula. So once again, two things you need. You need to know your monthly net pay, right? And net pay is what you take home after taxes. And you also need to know what is your monthly bill amount, meaning like your monthly expenses, right? Once you got those two totals, right? You need just a piece of paper. If you want to have a notebook, you go get a buy a notebook, right? And call it your budgeting book. And every week before when you get paid, right? Or any money, you know what I do? All right, let me tell you what exactly I do. You see, because I'm an entrepreneur, so I'm going to talk a little bit for the entrepreneurs now, right? Give me a second here, my W-2s. Let me talk to my 1099s for a little bit. For all the 1099 people, we're different. We don't have a steady paycheck that comes in every week, all right? We don't have a steady paycheck that comes in every 2 weeks and nothing like that, right? So what I tell all the entrepreneurs to do is that you got to run the 50-20-30 formula on everything that you get paid with. Any source of income that come into you, you better run the budgeting formula on that money. You understand what I'm saying to you? Run the budgeting formula on that money, no matter what. All right? Because like me, you know, I get paid like almost twice a week in my business, right? In what I do. So I get compensated twice a week. And because of that, you know, I have to make sure that I run a budgeting formula on every compensation that is coming into me, right? So that way I'm on track, and I got to make sure that at the end of my budgeting formula, I got to make sure that the first thing first is taken care of is my monthly expenses, right? Yes, I take care of my monthly expenses, but at the same time, I'm paying myself, right? So what I may do is that I may know early on that, hey, I can't go in the spending box yet. I can't spend. I got to keep putting towards everything over into there, but I still pay myself though. I pay myself 30%. I'm the most expensive bill in my house, hands down. Hands down, I'm one of the most expensive bill in my house, right? So when you gotta pay yourself, right? Just like it talks about in the Saving the Future book, I want you guys to remember this. Remember what it says in the Saving the Future book? It says, set aside, right? You gotta pay yourself first. It says, set aside 5-10% of your income to save for the future. If possible, save 15% or more. You gotta treat yourself like a bill. And that's the bill that you must pay, and you better pay it first because that's your family's financial bill. Now, doesn't it make sense to pay your family first, right? Think about that. Think about that. So the money that you're saving today, don't look at it like a punishment. Don't look at it like a chore. Don't look at it as something that you don't like to do. No, 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 no. It comes back to the very same thing that I said earlier. Live a lifestyle now that most people don't want to live, and you will live a lifestyle later that people could only dream about. You don't have to be at every party. You don't have to be at every birthday party. You don't have to be at every function. You don't have to go to every wedding. You don't have to be at every social gathering that is you're invited to, because you know why you're doing that. You understand? You got to know your why. The how will come. So it's important for us to understand these things, right? If you agree, hit me with that yes button, right? So now, how this is going to help us, let's break down the budgeting formula. The budgeting formula says, once again, two things you must know. Net pay, monthly bills, amount. Net pay, monthly bills, amount, all right? Let's break it down. First thing first, in every great thing, you must know the rules. Right? You must know the rules. So if you have a piece of paper right now, I want you to draw four boxes, right? Draw four boxes just like this. And as you can see in the top left box will be the rules box. You got to have rules, right? You must know the rules to living on a budget. So the rule says 50% of your income should go towards the bills. 20% of your income should go towards savings. And 30% of your income should go towards spending, right? So the formula also says for you to find the money for each section going forward, you always got to take your net pay times it by the percentage, and that equals money. Now, money for the bills, money for the savings box, money for the spending box, all right? So Here's the thing that I'm going to let you know, the reality that you're going to face very quickly when you do this. You're going to realize that maybe 50% of your income does not cover your bills, right? And you have two things that you could do, right? Actually, a few, but I'm just going to name like two or three. If 50% of your income does not cover your monthly expenses, you have two things you could do. You could just downsize on some of the things that you have, like certain bills. Maybe you have cable. Maybe at this point you can't afford to have cable, right? Maybe you have some subscriptions, right? Maybe you have, I don't know, different things that you're involved with that you're taking money from you. So maybe you may have to readjust some of your monthly expenses that you acquired, because at this moment it can't be in your budget because you're realizing that, man, more than 50% of my income is going towards bills, right? Or the second thing you could do is that, say you do love those bills, say you love some of the things that you have acquired that you want to keep in your life. So you may have to increase cash flow, right? You may have to increase cash flow. You may have to start a business on a part-time basis, or you may have to get a second job, right? So if you want to keep those things in your life, right? So these are the two choices you may have if you realize that. But don't feel bad, though, because 95% of Americans cannot pay their bills with 50% of their income. That's not how America taught you to be. So over 95% can't do that. So that's just a reality that you want to realize immediately, that 50% of your income probably cannot cover. But if it did, oh my God, high five to you, right? Like a virtual high five, right? Because now it gives you the ability to enjoy the other things where you could save 20% and you could still spend 30%, or you could decide not to spend the 30%, right? So, you know, it gives you more flexibility if you can cover most of your expenses with 50% of your income, right? And it's important that we do this. So now, the next thing is on the top right box, that's your bills box, right? That would be your bills box. And that's where you take net pay times that by 0.50, and that would equal the money for the bills, right? So that's how you figure out how much you have for the bills there, right? Then the next thing you do is that you look at the savings box, where you take net pay times that by 0.20, and that equals money for savings, right? Remember, you need to save at least 5 to 10%, 15% or more, right? I told you, I save 30%. I don't care if it's $60 is my commission that come in for that week. I 50, 20, 30 it all the time. I don't care. I'm such an expensive bill that I go overboard. I really do. I spend less trying to save more because, like I said, I'm trying to live a lifestyle now that most people would never want to live. If people see how I live, they would never believe it. They'd be like, oh my God, why? And I said, man, it's because I'm trying to be a billionaire. I'm not trying to be a millionaire. I'm trying to be a billionaire, man, right? And I got to sacrifice right now and make sure that I put the right things to work for me to get to that goal, right? So the next thing is you got to look in the spending box. The spending box is that you're going to take your net pay times it by 0.30, and that will equal money for spending, right? And when you think about it, you know, when you have all of this here, because now you have the rules, you have the formula in front of you. But what it looks like when you add money to it, right? How does it work? Now, let me give you an example. Let's say, right, hypothetically speaking, let's say that your bills, your monthly expenses was $2,400, right? Your monthly bills was $2,400. And let's say that you brought in a net pay of $3,000, right? You have a net pay of $3,000 coming into you. Now, what does that mean for you? What does that mean for you when you look at these formula? Now, it means that let's say that the goal is to find enough money to pay the bills, right? You make $3,000 net pay. So let's look in the bills box. What's the first thing we're going to do? We're going to take your net pay, which is the $3,000, times it by 0.50, right? I hope you guys are following me. And then that will equal $1,500. So at that moment, $1,500 does not pay the bill for $2,400. So then you come down to the savings box. You got to find all the money. You got to put all the money on the paper first, right? So now you go in the savings box and you're going to take a net pay again, $3,000 times by 0.20. That gives you $600, right? So now you have that there, you know what you can save. So the next thing that you got to look at is, next thing you got to look at is where you look at the spending box and you say, well, if you're going to take $3,000 times it by 0.30, that gives you $900. So what I want to ask you guys, if you're now looking at this, say this is your monthly bill, right? Let's say this is your monthly bill. And say, let's say this is your net income. You have a choice now, right? You have an important choice. And the choice that I want to ask you guys is that, where would you take the money from, right? Where should you take the money from? Should you take the money from your spending box to put towards the bills? Or should you take it from the savings box to put towards the bills? So if you think you should put it from, take it from your savings box to add to the bills, I want you to hit no. And if you think you should take it from the spending box, I want you to hit yes. What you guys think? Let me see what everybody is thinking. Go in your participant section and hit either yes or no. So no is from the savings box and yes is from the spending box. So I say, Jaime say spending. I see Ms. Sheila Forbes says spending, right? Anybody else say spending or who says savings box? Who on here said the savings box? I see Ms. Beverly said the spending box, right? All right, so nobody believed that it should come from the savings box. I see Swan says spending box, okay. See Chantal says from the spending box as well. All right, awesome. So now let's do the math, right? If you take the money from the spending box and added the $900 to that $1,500, you realize that you'd have got $2,400, which will take care of the monthly bills while you still could save 20%, which is that $600, right? So let's say you say, man, Keyon, then what about if I want to enjoy myself? How do I get to enjoy myself, Keyon? I don't want to just work for save and I don't get to have fun. Is that what you're saying? No, not at all. Now we just know that, remember, on page 8 in the Saving the Future book, what it says, pay yourself 5 to 10%. So if you break down that 10% into 10%, right? Now, what does that mean? It means that you break it down to $600 in half. So 10% represent 300, right? 10% represent 300. So now you could save 10%, which is the 300 for your retirement, and then you could split the other 10% in half, have 5% as your monthly budget that you can spend and still put another 5% towards emergency fund. So now you can enjoy $150 for your spending budget for the month, right? That's your budget for the month. You can't spend over $150, but then you can still put away $150 towards an emergency fund and start build up your emergency fund at the same time too. So this is how simple it is, guys. And this is how awesome it is to really live on a budget. And that's why living on a budget is so important, guys, because you can really start taking control of your finances and you can really start doing some amazing things, right? So at this moment, guys, I would love to open up the call to anyone that would like to share. So if you'd like to share, please press the yes button. And I would love to hear some of you guys' takeaway from some of the things that you learned today, or also what are some of the things that you've been implementing from the budgeting formula, if you have any testimonies from the budgeting formula working for you and your family as well, and how's it been going. So first person we have Jaime Gonzalez. Hey, Jaime, good morning, brother.
Good morning, everybody. Great money talks, Keyon, as usual. I love seeing the budgeting formula. I love it. Every month, me and my girlfriend have been doing it for the past 2 months, and she was living by spreadsheets, and I was telling her last week, get rid of all of them. Just throw them all out. We don't need them anymore. It's 4 boxes now. She's like, wait, what? How does that work? And I'm like, all right, I'm going to show you. I'm going to break it down, income, savings, spending. And she's like, all right, this is how it's going to work. But one question she did have, right, because we do all of our expenses. We keep track of our expenses as well. So the rent gets paid on the first, but the money comes out of the money that you've been saving from the previous month. So how would I put that into my tracker?
You said the rent was about the rent again? Do that again?
The rent is the money that you had made from last month, but it gets paid to the next month, right? So how would I put that into my budget? Do I account that from last month Or is it this month, technically?
Okay, well, the budgeting formula, right? You kind of have an idea of what your monthly income is, right? On a regular basis. Like, do you guys know what your net pay like?
Yeah, we know all of that and everything. I was just, because, you know, like, so I did all the expenses for July and everything. And then I'm looking at it and I'm like, should I take this? And I'm like, no, I'm getting paid again. So it should go towards August, right? The rent.
So right. One of the things I'll tell you, you see like how this month already started?
Right.
You already, because it's still in the beginning of the month, so you still could literally plan going into next month. So one of the things I always advise is that when you're running the money formula, right, the budget formula, you got to make sure that you plan it out for the first or at least a week before the next month coming in. So that way you can know what you're going into the month with, right? And what's your budget? So if you know for a fact that going into, let's say, August of this month, right? You know going into August that, hey, I can't afford to go over $300 as our monthly spending ability, right? Mm-hmm. So once you know that's your budget, then everything that you're making up until the point where you need to pay your rent are paying in monthly bills, that's how you work your way towards that, right? And then the next thing too is that if you could move your bills to like a certain time of the month where everybody's coming out of that certain time of the month, it's either the first week of the month or the second week of the month, you know, all your bills are coming out, you kind of having a better idea to really control it even more then too.
Right.
Yeah, like all of my bills come out on my birthday day, the 23rd. That's my day. I always say the 23rd is like the death of me. Right? The 23rd Keyon going nowhere.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah. Except for this year. This year my daughter is on the 23rd, so yeah. Got two big bills.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that, I hope that gives you some insight on that one.
Yeah, that was it. Thank you.
You're welcome. Anybody else like to share? You can just press yes or raise your hand. We'd love to hear your feedbacks, as always. We have Ms. Victoria Gordon, and then we have Chantal Maggie. Good morning, Ms. Victoria. I think you're still muted, Ms. Victoria. Let me see if I can help you out there.
Got it.
There you go.
Good morning, everybody. Great call. Awesome. I love that method for budgeting. It has put me ahead of the game since I've been on these calls and a part of this campaign. I kind of do like you do at the end of the month. I have my major bills are ready for the first of the month. So I'm like really ahead of the game. And if anything my testimony was I had a property tax that snuck up on me, which was an error of theirs, but still in order to keep me from going to the credit bureau, it's going to take them 3 to 6 months to straighten it out. So I still had to pay it, but I kept my paperwork. But I love this formula. It is awesome. It works. And I'm just excited because I was ready for the first to pay that rent. Everything was ready to go by the first. I made sure at the end of the month, everything was there and I was ready to pay all my bills. Boom, boom, boom. And any unnecessary things, like I don't do cable. Never did that. My kids could tell you that. They felt like they were the only kids in school with no cable. But anyhow, I don't do cable. I have one phone. I know people have like a landline and the cell phone. I was like, there's no need for that. I can only talk on one or the other. So I minimized that bill. I just minimized a lot of things that I felt that wasn't necessary so I could stay on top of my budget. So great call.
Oh, man. Thank you for that awesome share. And definitely big congratulations on the wins, man. That's what it's all about. I think we have Shanta Maggie as well. Good morning.
Hi, good morning, everybody. Great call, Keyon. I just wanted to really share that I really benefited from using this budget formula. Previously, I would add on extra expenses without checking with my budget first and then wonder why I have no money at the end of the month. But now, before I add any extra expenses, I have to look and see if my spending category, well, my bills category can actually afford to have another monthly bill. So I think that's like a great way to keep myself in check. And then also with regards to like making payments, et cetera, now if I have like Jaime was mentioning, having the bill that's kind of coming up, but the money has already been there for the prior month, I kind of consider that my old money and new money. So if I can pay my bills with old money, that's like amazing. And it's like a great feeling to be able to do that instead of being living paycheck to paycheck. So I'm really grateful for this budgeting formula.
Oh, you're very welcome. And you know, one more thing too, guys, that, you know, Chantal just brought to my mind that I was going to share with you guys. Another thing, if you have leftover money from your emergency fund or from your spending ability, right? Like your budget that you can spend for the month. If you have extra of that money left over each month, don't go into the next month and say, "Ooh, I can spend more money this month." No. What I want you guys to do, whatever you have left over, put it away. Put it away in the emergency fund or add it towards your savings ability. You understand? Add it to the savings, add it to the spend, to the emergency fund. Add it on. Don't look at it like it's extra money for you to spend. Now, I want you guys to get in the habit of spend less, save more. All right? Remember, spend less, save more, and it will be such an amazing. You would thank me. You would thank me a month from now, literally. All right? We have Miss Jennifer. All right. Good morning, Miss Jennifer. It's such a pleasure to see you on.
Good morning. How are you?
How are you?
Good. So, I like the budget formula. It's very interesting. And I guess when I think about it, like it definitely makes a lot of sense. I just kind of wish I would have, started using it a long time ago, because I have my own habits that I feel like work for me. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to try to adapt it as much as possible. But one of the things that I know I need to do increase money for my bills is to get rid of cable. So I was just wondering, like, what other resources are there?
One of the things that I do personally, I'm literally Netflix and internet. Oh, and okay. YouTube. I'm big on YouTube. YouTube have a whole bunch of free movies on there. You just got to deal with the ads. I don't mind. I skip them. You understand? Or I use my Netflix. And, you know, internet's cheaper. It's way cheaper.
Okay.
Man, that's one of the things I do. You know, and I tell people right there, I'm like a literally Netflix and chill type of guy. Or Hulu, whatever, right? It's so okay. Much. It's very, very, in these modern times, you can avoid paying so much.
Right.
You can really avoid paying so much. You can.
Yeah, I just, you know, with the budget formula, I need to learn new habits. And it's just going to take a little time.
Of course. It definitely takes, it took me a while. Yeah. You know,
but it's good. I like it.
Yeah, keep coming to money talk. I'm telling you, it just comes naturally after a while.
Okay.
I think Chantal wanted to say something real quick, and then I'm going to get to you, Miss Sheila.
Okay. Yeah, I was just going to add to that with like Netflix, because I did the same thing. I got rid of cable and I had my own Netflix account, but then now I kind of take it to another step and I use my family's Netflix account. Because I'm like, even that $5, I'm not going to pay for it if someone else has it and they can create an account for me under theirs. And then I try to find things like that in everything. So like even like my BJ's card, I used to pay the $25 or the $50 for the membership. My mom has it. Now I use hers. My gym membership that I never used, I ended up freezing it and I'm going to try to get rid of it as soon as I can. So that way I don't have that extra $30 per month, and just trying to find ways with every single bill, no matter how small or how big it is, to get rid of it or minimize it. Right. So I literally just went through every single transaction that comes through my bank account and I'm like, how can I cut this? How can I get rid of this? And just try to find ways to do that. So I just recommend everybody to get creative, because I didn't realize how much I was spending on things that I didn't actually really need. And I was able to cut at least $400 to $500 worth of monthly spending just from things that I did not need at all.
Yeah, it's crazy. That's why we do that personal financial strategy with our clients, and we look at the entire portfolio. We look at the entire monthly expenses and we just go through it like a you know, what do you also say with a fine-tooth comb? Yeah.
Yeah. When we did that, I was like, oh my goodness, I have a problem.
But you know, sometimes it's hard for you to be honest with yourself because you could justify your spendings. But when someone else looking at it, they could really be honest with you and you could be honest with them as well. And because at the end of the day, it only helps you, right? And it's almost like you got to say, hey, I have an addiction. Yep, first step, right? And you just got to be open to be helped.
Yep. Thank you.
Oh, you're very welcome.
Hey, can I just jump on that 1 second?
Yeah, sure. I'll take one more and then I'll go to Ms. Sheila Forbes.
Okay. So I want to say I have the box from the Obama time on one of my TVs so I can watch my regular channel with the news within my state. So that works too. Still got the rabbit ears. It's free.
Yes. Yes, the rabbit ears definitely work. My mom is a big fan of that one. Oh, man. I grew up in Jamaica, so we had the big old antenna outside on the house. You know, anybody from Jamaica know that one. And Ms. Sheila Forbes, good morning. What is it? Happy Wednesday, right? It's Wednesday. Happy Wednesday, guys.
Yeah. Happy Wednesday. Hey, all the comments have just been amazing and it just summed everything up. That budgeting formula is a game changer, and it doing that and doing the Legacy Shield calculator to calculate my debts, and that even helped those two together. Help me get some things paid off so much quicker, and it's helping me to get my bills down to that 50%. Once I hit that mark, it is going to be an amazing difference to what I am able to build and how fast I am able to build. If you're serious about what you're doing and really truly trying to get there, all you have to do is to implement these simple things. And I say it's simple, but you know, I have problems too, you know, like coming home from work, net drive, and I'm trying to think of something to eat. And I call my husband and he be like, I don't know, ain't got a taste of nothing. And then, you know, it's so easy to like pick up something. So my biggest spending habit is food. It's going out to eat because, you know, it's the cooking thing. And so, and so just making those little adjustments every week and not, and it's so easy to fall in that trap. It is so easy. Like every day is like, okay, we can just go home and eat something. We can find something in the refrigerator. So it's not, you know, having to have this full course meal every day, but just have something to be satisfied and just be done with it. So I like it and I like teaching it. I love our campaign because teaching it helps me stay on point too, helps me stay on task. Because when I'm teaching it, I'm like, you know, I'm like, oh yeah, I need to check on that. Oh yeah,
am I doing it? It reminds me. It's a reminder. And so I just appreciate these money talk calls because it gets you thinking about stuff in early in the morning so that I can start checking on some more stuff. So I'm just excited. Loved all the comments. Thank you again for these money talk calls. They are just truly amazing. Thank you.
You're welcome. And one more thing I'll give you guys. When you get a financial review done, don't just do it once a month, right? Don't just do it one time. I always say every quarter, you must have a review done to see, hey, the first quarter, how close am I to my yearly goal? What is your yearly goal? What is your yearly savings goal, right? Like for me, I want to get to a point where I could save, $200,000 a year, right? So at least I know within the next 5 years, that's $1 million saved up, right? So you got to have a savings goal. What is your goal? You can't just save, say I'm going to save. But what is your goal, right? What is your savings goal? And you got to have a savings goal. You got to have something that you're fighting towards, right? What is your goal to be debt-free, right? You got to have a goal for that. What is your goal as far as the emergency fund you want to have saved? How quick do you want to have 36 months of your income saved up? What's your goal? You got to have a deadline on it and you got to work. That's why I am the way I am, guys, because I'm so goal-driven. I really am. I'm a goal-driven type of guy, you know, because if I have a goal on something, I'll say it, but behind the works, I'm working day and night on it, you know? Like, I'm obsessed with my goals. Like, if I want something, I won't stop until I get it. I won't. You can't stop me. I must have it. Plus the affirmations and my actions, I'm deadly with that. You know, I'll take one more and then we'll close out. Ms. Beverly Williams, good morning.
Good morning and good morning, everyone. And thanks for the money talk and the affirmations. Oh my God, I am just so psyched. And I have a testimony because you already know that I paid off those cars. But I just went through a refi, which is something that I would never, ever do. And I shaved 7 months off of my 30 years. So, and then if everything goes well, I told him how much I was gonna additionally pay on my mortgage. And he says, oh my God, if you do that, you'll pay your house off in 15 years. So Money talk really works. And I'm talking about, I've only been in my house for a year. So if I can go from 30 years to paying it off in 20, I actually won't sell it because I was trying to think about selling and downsizing. But because of money talk and debt roll up, I am looking to stay here like I wanted to begin with when I purchased this house and pay it off and still be young enough to enjoy it still. So thank you, Keyon, for the money talks. They work. Budgeting works. Just make it work for you. I wanted to say Roku to the young lady who didn't want to get rid of your TV. I understand. My husband likes that crazy, stupid car channel. So I have Roku boxes, one-time charge, Walmart or Sam's. And I hooked it to my additional TVs in the house and I use my internet. So just wanted to throw that extra out there. So everybody enjoy your day. That's all I got to say. Right.
Thank you for that awesome share, Ms. Beverly.
If I could just add to the thing, if you guys just Google free TV shows, free movie streaming sites, I found multiple streaming sites that's free. I get free sports, free TV, free movies. You guys can just Google it or just ask around and it's out there. You don't have to pay for cable or anything anymore.
Wow. See that? See what money talks about? Resources. We all got so much great resources, guys. Free. All right. Say it one more time again, Jaime, just for everybody that missed it. One more time.
You could Google how I found a few sites that allow me to watch free movies, all the brand new movies that just came out. You just Google free movie streaming site or Google free sports streaming site. And now I watch basketball whenever I want. I watch all the new movies whenever I want. I give my girlfriend $5 for Netflix if I want to watch something on there, you know, and that the sharing of apps and subscription thing, I don't pay more than $20 a month to watch, and I watch whatever I want to watch.
See, I was really getting the information for me, so thank you, Jaime. I was just trying to put it out like it's a group thing. All right, guys. Wow. Powerful money talk. I'm telling you, I love these talks. You know, I hope you guys keep learning and getting more resources, and they get better and better. So tomorrow, oh man, tomorrow, we're going to break down investments. All right. We're going to talk about different investments. We're going to talk about tax tolerance, risk tolerance. We're going to talk about the different type of risk tolerance that you should have. And you should also, we're also going to talk about the different kind of tax tolerance you should have and how do they work together, right? So you don't want to miss tomorrow. So thank you guys for tuning in. My name is Keyon Corniffe, also known as Mr. Finance. And always remember that you are one decision away from changing the future for the better. So always remember, the choice is yours. So on the count of three, let's all wish out. And one more announcement, tonight, Wednesday night, every 8 p.m. Eastern time, we have our financial workshops that are available to the public and everyone. So please don't miss them. If you would like to have access to these workshops for tonight at 8 p.m. Eastern time, please get in touch with a campaigner that invited you to this money talk, and they will send you the link so you can register for it. It's free and you get to come and learn. It's going to be an incredible workshop. And as always, the classes are always amazing and they're very fast. It's literally from 8 to 9. All right. So don't miss it. So on the count of three, guys, let's all wish out. 1, 2, 3. Let's wish, guys.
World team. One dream. One system. One cause.
Have a great day, everybody. See you guys later.